To access the CPS online store, you can visit directly by typing in your URL shop.cpsdistributors.com. Alternatively, if you start at our regular website, cpsdistributors.com, on the top right, there's this red button, Shop CPS Online. Go ahead and click that button. You'll be directed to our login screen. If you're an existing online store user, go ahead, enter your username, which is going to be the email that you registered with, your password that you registered with, and click Sign In. If you forgot your password, please go ahead, click Forgot Password, and reset it through your email. If you have not yet registered for the online store, please go ahead and click this button, click here to register. Fill out the registration form to the best of your ability. Important to note that this job title field is what is going to set the access right for you on the online store. So if you're a business owner, make sure to select Customer Admin to have full access rights to the online store. If you're not a business owner, please select the relevant job title, fill out the registration form to the best of your ability, and click Submit Login Request. We will receive your request and get it approved as soon as possible. If we have any questions about the account, we will reach out to the company owner directly for confirmation of your request. Upon successful login, for those of you that have CPS accounts that have multiple ship-tos associated to your account, you will first be prompted to make a ship-to selection. To do so, click on the available ship-tos, select the appropriate ship-to, click Continue, and confirm your selection. Once you've made a ship-to selection, or if your account doesn't use ship-tos, you will arrive at our main shopping page. In the header, you'll notice a welcome message. Welcome, your name, your company name, your selected job or ship-to account, your customer ID number, and your default pickup branch. Your selected pickup branch is going to determine where your order writes to, or where it is shipped out of, or where it is made available for a pickup or will call. You'll want to make sure to make the proper branch selection before you start your checkout process. If you need to change your selected branch, click on Change Pickup Location, make your selection from one of our 15 CPS locations, and click Save Changes. And you are now free to move about the country. Just kidding, but really, you are free to shop over 10,000 stock SKUs from CPS distributors. We show customer-specific pricing on products, and we show availability at all of our CPS locations. The two main methods of product search are either search by category or search by keyword. To search by category, you can either click in one of the image category thumbnails in this menu found here, or you can navigate our main menu to see the main categories and the associated subcategories of those main categories. To search by keyword, simply click in the search bar, type in your keyword. This can be a part number, a keyword, or any related term to that product, and click search. When you arrive on a product listing page, it's important to note that the pricing that you will be shown is the pricing specific to your account. This is not list price. This is the price that you can expect to pay at any of our CPS counters. Additionally, we are showing whether or not that product is in stock based on your selected pickup branch. If you want to see whether or not an item is in stock at all of our CPS branch locations, you can simply mouse over the word check next to in stock, and in the pop-up, you can see whether or not that item is in stock at all of our locations. By default, we are showing 25 items per page. You can change this to show up to 100 items per page. You are presented a grid view by default. If you would prefer a list view, click on the icon here in the top right, and you will be presented a list view of the items on that page. A very valuable tool for searching out products is found in the left column of the product listing page. The filter by feature allows you to narrow down your search by specific attributes. For instance, you may want a specific vendor, a specific color, and for these irrigation nozzles, a specific radius. You'll now be presented with a more focused product listing based on your attributes. If you would like to view further product details, you can either click on the part number or click on the image thumbnail to get to the product detail page. Here, you'll be shown additional product details along with item specifications. When you've located the products that you would like to add to your shopping cart, either for checkout or to save for future use in a reorder pad, go ahead and click an item quantity and click Add to Cart. Once all your desired products are added to your shopping cart, you can view your shopping cart by clicking on the shopping cart icon up here on the top right. Once in the shopping cart, you'll be presented a collection of the items that you've added to the cart. If there are any stocking issues on any of your items, it will call out here that it needs your attention, and you can see down here specifically what is out of stock at your selected quantity because it will be colored in pink. Important to note, the system will still allow you to place an order on an out-of-stock item. As always, CPS will source that product internally to get it where you need it, when you need it, and if that can't happen, we will call you to discuss options. If there are any last-minute items that you forgot and you know that item part number, you can utilize our quick add feature. Type into the field, add the CPS specific part number, and click add. If you would like to quick add multiple line items at one time, utilize the shopping list feature. Click on shopping list, type the item number and the desired quantity of that item, and you can tab through and add as many as you need to. If you need to add more rows to the shopping list, click add row and add as many as you'd like. When done, click add items to cart. The system will validate your entered part numbers to make sure that they are accurate, and it will add all of the listed items to your shopping cart. If you would like to save a collection of your shopping cart items for future use in a reorder pad, on the top right, you will click Save as Reorder Pad. More on that later. For now, we'll assume these are the items that you would like to check out with. We'll go ahead and click Checkout. From here, there's a mandatory PO field. Ship via is a shipping method that you would like. If you would like CPS to deliver it on one of our trucks, click Deliver CPS Truck. Or if you're going to come and pick it up at the branch, select Pickup or Will Call. Or if you're one of our customers that are outside of our ship and delivery zone, or for whatever reason, you need a custom carrier ship and option, go ahead and make that selection. We will contact you post-order to discuss those options further. The requested date is the date that you would like to either pick up the order or have it delivered to your job site. Enter a requested date that you would like the order to be delivered or be available for pickup. If you have any specific instructions related to the order, please leave it in the order notes. This is limited to 54 characters, but something short and sweet, like drop it in the back next to the dumpster or call me when ready. I'll be in at noon to pick it up. Please leave it there. Click continue, and you will be presented with the final order screen confirming the contents of your order. You will agree to the terms and sales conditions and click submit order. If you would like to share the order acknowledgement with any of your coworkers, please make that selection from your list of available coworkers and click Submit Order. Once you click Submit Order, that order is going to write directly to our system, and it's going to notify every one of our employees at that branch that that order has been submitted, at which point one of our employees is going to claim that order and start working it. If they have any questions, concerns, or need to contact you for any reason, they will call your number listed on your account. In addition to product research, product pricing, and submitting orders electronically, the CPS Online Store also serves as a robust account management tool. To access your account management dashboard, in the top right, click on Account Tools, My Account. From here, you'll be presented a suite of online account management tools. You may or may not see some of these functions according to your user access rights. From left to right, Invoices is going to show invoice history with complete detail on line item specifics of the order, going as far back as we have information for your company in our system. This is not only orders that you've placed online, this is the entirety of your purchase history with CPS. Open orders are for currently pending orders that have not yet invoiced out. Here, you'll be shown the list of open orders. You can click on the order to get a specific line-by-line detail of the order, and you'll also see the process of that order, whether it's been picked, shipped, delivered, and so on. Order statements is for those who have established credit with CPS. Here you'll see an overview of your credit standing and then which of your invoices is current within a 30, 60, or a 90-day collection bid. Held orders is for a supervisory role that we have on the website, where if you have an employee who does not have the access right to submit order, it will store here and trigger an email to the set supervisor on that user to claim that order and continue the checkout process. Account admin is used for an owner of a company to add or edit existing users. This way, you don't have to require an employee to go and fill out the registration process anew. Instead, you can create the users yourself and set their specific access rights on the online store. If you need to change your personal account information, you can do so in customer information. You can change your password, your reorder pads, a huge time saver. We'll come right back to those. You could shop now, or if you click help, you can email our web team and we will respond as soon as possible. We'll briefly go over all of these features, but because it's such a huge time saver and such a popular feature with a lot of our customers, we will start with reorder pads. There are two ways to access your reorder pads. You can go to Account Tools and select Reorder Pad. Otherwise, from your account dashboard, and since we're here already, we will click into Reorder Pads from here. Reorder Pads are customized company-wide collections of group products built for easy future purchasing. These might be frequently purchased items list, job-specific item list, or assembly-specific, like you see here, a Backflow Central assembly. As I said, reorder pads are a huge time saver, so it's well worth the time to take a few moments, familiarize yourself and your team with how to use them, get with your counter staff or your sales rep, and build some pads that are valuable to your team. When you first get to your reorder pad page, as you see here, you will see a collection of all your company-wide reorder pads. To view the details of a reorder pad, click on the reorder pad title to expand the toggle. Once expanded, you will see a collection of items that are stored in the reorder pad. To change the quantity of an item in your reorder pad, simply click in the quantity, select the value you would like to be stored, and from the options menu on the top right, click Update Reorder Pad. The quantity values are stored according to the last update you made on your reorder pad. If you'll be making an addition to your shopping cart from your reorder pad, you may not want every line item that's in that reorder pad. To withhold certain items from being added to your order, you can simply zero out that field. Here, the keyboard comes in handy as you can tab through, make your adjustments as you go down the list, and when finished, at the bottom, click Add Items to Cart. As I mentioned, those items that have a quantity of zero will not be added to your cart. To make this process easier, we've added an option in the options dropdown, Reset Quantities to Zero. This way, you'll start with the blank slate, and then you can simply tab through to the items that you want, enter the desired quantity, and when finished, click Add All Items to Cart. Other available options in the options dropdown on the reorder pad are to delete a reorder pad. You'll want to remember that your reorder pads are company-wide. If you create a reorder pad, all of your fellow employees and coworkers are going to have exposure to that reorder pad. So be careful if you delete a reorder pad that somebody else created, that they in fact do not rely on that reorder pad. You can also print your reorder pad list if you ever have a need to do that. If you click your reorder pad, it's going to format it in a nice, easy to consume manner for printing. You can also export a reorder pad if you need a spreadsheet of that reorder pad for whatever reason. By default, reorder pads will show pricing and availability. If for whatever reason you would like to hide pricing and availability, click on the checkbox here, Show Pricing Availability, and you will have a list with no pricing and availability. You may use this if you're working with a customer who requests a price list for the items that you used on their job, if you've hypothetically created a reorder pad specific to their job and you do not want to share your customer pricing with them. So now that we've explored the reorder pads and their functionality, the question is, how do you create a reorder pad? The important thing to remember is that all reorder pad creation starts in the shopping cart. Once you have a desired collection of items in your shopping cart and you would like to save that as a reorder pad for future use, go ahead and click Save as Reorder Pad on the top right of the shopping cart. You will then be prompted whether you want to create a new reorder pad or if you want to add to or replace an existing reorder pad. So if we had an existing reorder pad and we had a few items that we forgot to add or we wanted to add there, we would select the existing reorder pad from our list and we would select Add to Reorder Pad, or if we wanted to replace it entirely, replace that reorder pad and click Save Reorder Pad. In this case, we want to create this entirely new, so we're going to go here, we're going to give it a title, and we'll add a little note to remind us what this is, and we will create that reorder pad. And now back on the reorder pad page, we can see here that it's created this new reorder pad web demo. Next, we will take a look at customer invoice history. Yes, these are an amazing way to go back in time and look up past invoices for whatever need you have, whether it's accounting or you're trying to track a certain product that you bought on a certain date. But the invoice history can also serve as an amazing tool to create reorder pads based on your past history. Let's take a look. To view your invoice history, simply click on Invoices. Once you arrive at the invoice history search page, you will be presented a list of invoices going back 90 days. By default, we're showing you 10 entries. However, you can change this at any time by showing up to 100 per page. If you have a need to view invoice history beyond 90 days, you can utilize our search feature here to select a beginning date and an end date and click Find Invoices. If you want to use keyword search to search by PO on invoice history, simply start typing the PO name into the search field. Of course, the accuracy of this search depends on the accuracy of how the POs are used at your company. Nonetheless, this can be a great tool to narrow down by PO. Once you've narrowed down your invoice search and you've located an order detail that you would like to view, simply mouse over and click on the blue link of the invoice number. From here, you'll be presented the order details. In this case, it looks funny because it's our demo account, but you will see your relevant information there, the order date, who it was ordered by, the order number, and so on, along with the line item details of each item and each quantity bought with. From here, you'll have a capability to individually add a line item directly to your shopping cart, or to add all of the items to your shopping cart. Like the reorder pads, you can zero out quantities on items you don't want and change quantities on items to which you need and click Add All to Cart. So as I mentioned, the invoice history can be a really great way to easily add previously purchased items to your shopping cart to save for a reorder pad. An example I often give of that is if you do a large early season order to stock up your yard every year and you are repeating a similar order year after year, you could take the guesswork out of building that list entirely, shopping the store, adding it to your cart. You could go to your previous year early order, add all those items to your cart, save as reorder pad, and then make whatever needed changes or addition once those items are stored directly in your reorder pad. Your CPS sales rep or myself or any of our counter staff can walk you through that process. Back on our account management dashboard, we will touch on the remaining features in the account management dashboard. Open orders is the same as invoice history. The one exception, it's going to give you an overview on the current status of that order in our system, whether that order has been picked, shipped, or if it's currently out for delivery. Order statements is for CPS customers who have established credit accounts with CPS. On the account statement page, you will be given an overview of your CPS credit statement. You will see your total balance, you'll see what is within current terms, And then if any are overdue, you will see if they are within 30, 60, or 90 days overdue. Additionally, down below, you can see the individual invoices and their current credit standing in our system. Held orders is a unique feature to the online store where you can set an employee to only be able to place orders that are put on hold for a supervisor to then take control of. In this scenario, you will reach out to us directly to set this up, and when that user places an order, the set supervisor will receive an email with a link to the order to take over the order and check out. Account admin is for users that have the access right customer admin to add or edit existing users. Once you click into the account admin feature, you will choose whether you want to add a new user or edit an existing user. Edit an existing user would be if you need to make a basic change on that user, or if you've had an employee who has left the company, you'll want to be sure to go ahead and disable that user, preventing them from still having access to your CPS account. To add a user, click on the Add User icon. Your company name and customer number cannot be switched. Put in the employee name, and you'll want to be careful about selecting their job title, as this will set their access rights on the online store. If you have a user who is not an owner at your company, we suggest that you do not select customer admin because they will have full access rights to add or edit users just like you are here, and you could be one of those users who's being disabled, so you'll want to proceed carefully when selecting your employee's job title. Fill out the rest of the information to the best of your ability, put in a temporary password, and click Add User. You will have to relay that temporary password to your employee, and once they log in, they can change it, or they can visit the login screen, click Forgot Password, enter their email that you set for them when you created the user, and reset the password through their email. Customer info is used if you need to make basic personal information adjustments on your account information. If you need to change your password, you could do so in the Change Password feature. The reorder pads are already covered. Shop Now will bring you to the homepage. And lastly, help will email our web team. During business hours, our web team is on standby to help you with any of your online shopping needs that you have. If you can't find a product or you want to schedule an online webinar or demo with you and your team, please reach out as soon as possible and we will get that set up. You can call your local branch for help, you can reach out to your local sales rep, or you can use this help button to email our web team directly. If you have any ideas of how we can improve your online shopping experience, we would love to hear about it. Also, if you have any unique scenarios where you're trying to integrate your software with our online store platform, we would love to hear from you and brainstorm together how we could achieve that. Thanks for taking the time to watch this demonstration. At CPS, we truly believe that your time matters, and it's our hope that the online store will help you improve your buying efficiencies, your business operations, and increase your bottom line. Thank you for taking the time to watch this, and I hope to hear from you very soon.